Welcome back, aliens. I'm Navin Reddy from Toy School Learnings, and today we are going to talk about Maven. Hold on, we have already heard about that in one of the videos, right? So if you have seen my last video, I've talked about Maven. But then after that, I have talked about different technologies like Hibernate, Spring, and then we are going to start with REST now. So I want to make sure that you know this topic thoroughly. So let's start with it. So Maven is basically a build tool, and it is under a license of Apache. And if you go to Maven repository, there are lots of libraries available. But hold on. Why do we even need a Maven thing? So basically what happens, you know, when you want to work with a new project, I mean, when you want to create a project, of course, you need some third-party libraries, right? Example, let's say if you want to create a project where you want to work with MySQL. So if you get a Java application, if you want to connect with MySQL, what you need is MySQL connector. So that's one of the dependencies you need. So you need a MySQL connector. The second thing is, let's say if you're also working with Spring. So when you work with Spring MVC, you need lots of dependencies, right? In fact, when you talk about Spring MVC, we need minimum at least 10 or 12 libraries, what you say, or Java files. For Hibernate, we require 10 or 11 libraries. Just imagine if you're working with all these frameworks, you have to download all this dependency by yourself. That's a difficult thing, right? So if you want to download everything by yourself, that's not a good thing. Okay, even if you do that, you will say, okay, I'm a programmer, I will download everything from the internet. That's fine. The thing is, when you do it by yourself, when you download all the video by yourself, the problem is, not video, the dependency by yourself, the problem is, in future, if you want to update it, so let's say from Spring 4, now you have to go for Spring 5, what you have to do is, you have to again go to Spring repository, and you have to download those dependencies. And trust me, it's a pain. Because first of all, you have to download the dependency. Second, you have to make sure that the dependency which you have downloaded for Spring is matching with the Hibernate dependency, right? And to solve this problem, we have a Maven repository. So Maven says, hey people, don't worry. Again, Maven has lots of advantages, like we have different goals to achieve. We can compile it, we can deploy using Maven. But here, the important point for me is getting those Java files, right? Because when you work on a project, those Java files are very, very important to work with. Now, question arises, how do you get those Java files? It's very easy, actually. You have to go to Maven repository and say, hey, Maven repository, I want Spring dependencies. Hey, Maven repository, I want Hibernate dependencies. And Maven will say, okay, so these are your Spring dependencies, these are your Hibernate dependencies, and you got it. Okay, if you're thinking about what is dependency, the Java files, right? So if you need certain Java files to work with some technologies, you need those are called the dependencies. So Maven will give you those jar or library dependency to you. But hold on, is Maven a Superman to do all those things or Superwoman to do all those things? Not exactly. So in Maven, you have to specify. So whenever you create a project, basically we have to remember some terms here. Now to understand Maven, you have to remember these terms. So first of all, the project. So what is project? Basically everything, whatever you create in Maven is basically a project. Now in that project, the most important file is this file, which is pom.xml. Now this is the file where you will mention everything. So if you need Hibernate, just mention there, hey, I want Hibernate. Not in this way, but we have a different syntax, okay? So we have to mention, hey, I need Spring. Again, not in this way, we have a different way of doing that. But this is the file where you have to mention to Hibernate, hey, I want, or to Maven, hey, I want these dependencies. The second thing you have to remember is something called as artifact ID, or let's go for group ID first. So next thing we need is group ID. Now what is group ID? See, there are different type of projects which build by different people, right? Or different companies. So if I'm building 5 projects, I want to make sure that each of my project is unique throughout the world. Okay, now how do we make sure that you're having a project which is unique throughout the world? So you have to make sure that the artifact ID which you are using is unique. Let's say if I give our artifact ID as demo, is it unique throughout the world? Not exactly, right? Anyone can create a project with demo name. How about if I create a project name as ABC, ABC1234, ABC1234, the big name. There's a chance that the name might repeat, right? And that's why what we do is we combine the group ID and the artifact ID. So artifact ID will represent your project name and group ID will define your package. Example, let's say if I'm making a project and I'm working for Telesco. So it would be com.telesco. That's my group ID. So all the project which we build will be a part of com.telesco and the project is, let's say, demo. So now we have com.telesco.demo. And of course, we have to make sure that we are not creating demo project once again, right? So that's your artifact ID, which is your demo, and your group ID is that com.telisco. Again, you can use the same thing as your package name. You can say com.telisco.demo.web. That's your package name, right? So you have to remember these terms, and your Maven will become very easy to you. So, okay, so now how do you mention in Maven that we want dependencies? So you can see it's a very simple POM file where you have dependency tab, dependencies tab. Now, if you want a Spring Java file, it's very easy. Just go to the official website of Spring so we can go to official website of Spring. You can copy that code. But then instead of going to individual website, like go to Spring website, go to Hibernate website, what you can also do is you can just go to an MVN repository, which is a central repository for all the Java files. Just go there and search for Spring. It will give you a code. Just go to your POM file and paste, and you will get your project back. I mean, you will get all your dependencies. That's awesome, right? And trust me, it works like a magic. Now question arises, if you don't have that Java file in your machine, that means it is coming from the internet, right? So whenever you work with Maven, you have to make sure that you are connected with the internet, and that's where the problem starts. Every time you create a project, you have to make sure that you're connected with the internet. That's not the case. What happens is when you are using Spring dependency for the first time, let's say if you're using Spring 4.3.8 for the first time, it will get downloaded from the remote repository. So Maven has a remote repository from where you get all the Java files. But it also has a local repository. So in your machine, you'll be having a local repository. So every time you ask for a dependency now, it will first search for local repository. If it is not there, it will go to remote repository. Now, next time when you search for it, you already have that in local repository, right? So it will increase your performance, or you can say it will reduce the time it takes to download those dependencies. So that's an awesome thing, right? So we can use Maven to build our project, and we can get all the Java files. Again, we have not talked about everything in Maven. It's a very big topic. This video is important for you, because if you want to learn about Spring, of course, all the project which you will build in Spring maybe will be based on Maven. Okay. Now, Maven is not the only way to do that. We also have a way which is called as Gradle. Now, if you have ever worked on Android, we use Gradle there. But then for web projects, for Java projects, most of us, we use Maven. But okay, we can also use Gradle in Java as well, okay? So yeah, that's it. That's about this Maven concept. I hope you got something about this. And we also have a practical video for this. You can see that it will be coming somewhere in the suggestion videos. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Just click on the like button and do subscribe for other videos.